Hey guys, this is Garrett, and thanks for checking out the Ignite Your Run series. Today I want to show you a very effective locomotion movement, and something that we have learned when we were little, and as we progress, we can start standing upright, walking, running. I think it's pretty obvious that a lot of people are lacking in this area, and it can drastically improve your running performance. Basically what that is crawling, and crawling patterns. So if you look at walking and running, what we need to work on is that opposite arm and opposite leg movement. I see a lot of people, once we start to move through different exercises, they're always going into kind of the same sided position. So what we don't have right there is that reciprocal pattern, really getting that opposite arm and opposite leg almost unconsciously moving together to get that reciprocal motion. So the low bear crawl is pretty good for that. Again, if you look at the low bear crawl and break it down to some of its other benefits, it helps improve core strength, shoulder stability, core stability. Biggest thing here for cyclists, especially if you're down in this position, what's called binocular vision, being able to be down into this position but still have that gaze upright to kind of see what's up in front of you. So to do the bear crawl, what I want to do is actually start with all fours on the ground. So we'll progress this in a second to make it a little more challenging. So in this position right here, we don't want to just kind of hang on this position, be slouched down. We want to slightly push into the ground, try to push ourselves up higher. Our back will slightly round in that position. And then from there, we're always thinking opposite arms and opposite leg. I want you just to try, again, without overly thinking this movement, just try and do a few steps forward of the crawl. See how you move. See if you go in your first reaction is to do the same side at the same time, or see if you automatically fall into that cross-crawl pattern. So you'll notice some people will automatically do this, same sides, but obviously that's not the way we want to move through. So we want to do opposites, and pushing into the ground. I'm trying to slightly pull my belly button in, engage through the core, opposite. Opposite. Okay, nice thumb control. From there we can also go backwards. So notice my toes are on the ground, my knees are on the ground, and my hands are on the ground. So I have 6 points of contact. So that's the most basic. Again, try that out right there. See how you feel. I think you'd be surprised at how you will automatically go to that same side as opposed to do the opposites. From there, if you find that it's pretty easy, you want to progress to the next level, we can go to the low bear crawl, which our knees are slightly elevated off the ground. So from this position here that we were just in, knees under the hips, hands under the shoulders, we're going to slightly go up on the toes, so those knees are slightly lifted. So from here, immediately, we get a lot more activation through the core. That core really has to fire to maintain a nice, solid midsection. So very similar to running. We're upright, our legs are moving forward and back, our arms are moving to improve and maintain an efficiency throughout the musculoskeletal system. We need to make sure that core is rigid. It's not, we don't have any excess motion. We're not going up, forward, and back. We're maintaining a good, solid, stable spine, which you actually get here from the low bear crawl. So from this position here, raise up on the toes, knees under hips, hands under the shoulders, opposites, opposite arm, opposite leg, opposite. So nice and slow. It's not a rush. Once we get forward, we can also move back. So I encourage you to look at your position. If you have a mirror that is low to the ground, look at the mirror. See if you automatically default to hips up. See if your low back is really arched. Is it really rounded? As you step, do you tend to rock side to side? If we can keep the body in a nice compact position, that's what we want, because we're maintaining stability. As you maintain stability in this low bear crawl, we'll actually be more efficient as we start to get upright through our running motion there. So there you go, try that low bear crawl. Again, surprising at how much that impacts our running performance. And let me know if you have any questions with that movement. Again, you won't see a lot of people doing the low bear crawl in this fashion. Take your time, go slow, really control yourself, and enjoy the benefits. Thank you.